folks. This is your host, Tammy Turner, and you are now listening to the Tiara Talk Show. We bring you rare interviews with the makers of Disney magic. Whether they be singers, actors, imagineers, animators, they've all made their mark on the Disney name. To find out more about the show and other episodes, head to our official website at www.thetiaratalkshow.com. Be sure to look below at the show notes in the Show More section for links to our Twitter and Facebook pages, including videos and websites mentioned in the following interview. Photos and audio clips that are featured in the show belong to their rightful owners and are used for educational purposes only. All guests' opinions are theirs and theirs alone and do not represent the opinions of the Tiara Talk Show or the host. The Tiara Talk Show is not associated with the Disney Company. Thanks again for tuning in to this week's episode, and from all of us here at the Tiara Talk Show, have a hoop-de-doo day. I'm excited to welcome this week's Tiara Talk Show guest, country singer Kellie Coffey, to the show. Welcome, Kellie.
Thank you.
Now, listeners will probably recognize your beautiful singing voice at the Disney theme parks because you sing the lead vocals for We Go On during Illuminations Reflections of Earth fireworks show at EPCOT. That's a mouthful.
That is. I've never heard the official title, but yes.
Well, it could be more official when you say Experimental Prototype Community of Tomorrow, because that's what EPCOT stands for.
So fantastic. I'm blown away. That's awesome.
That's my inner Disney geek coming out. But
I love that.
And then also the EPCOT exit theme Promises, which I really enjoy as well. The theme to Imagine a Fantasy in the Sky fireworks show in Disneyland and many others. And I got a chance to watch your documentary, Kellie Coffey, I'm Still Here, which listeners, please check it out. It's on YouTube. You can just type in the name Kellie Coffey, I'm Still Here. And you have an amazing singing background. You've performed in musicals, clubs, and also with Barbara Streisand, which we were talking about earlier before we hit the record button. But yeah. Can you remember your first performance on stage for an audience?
Oh my gosh, my first performance. Probably I was at church, and I probably was about maybe 11. A little. I was pretty little. So yeah, I used to sing at church every once in a while, and I loved that.
And your first music collaboration with the Disney Company was recording the song We Go On for Illuminations, Reflections of Earth for the new millennium of 2000. So the show has been playing almost every night at EPCOT since 1999, with 2014 marking the fireworks spectacular playing for 15 years, which is crazy.
That blows my mind. That is fantastic.
I didn't even realize it until I was just kind of looking through the years, and I was like, oh my goodness.
Yes, I think they say it's one of the longest running shows.
I'm not surprised, though.
I'm wondering if it's all parks or just Disney World, or I don't know.
I'm pretty sure, don't quote me on this, but I'm pretty sure it's just EPCOT at this point, because it was especially made for EPCOT with the pavilions in mind, because the pavilions take part in the show, except for Morocco, because of religious reasons.
Oh, really? Wow.
Yeah, their lights are dim during it, but they come back up after the whole thing. Yeah.
I did not know this. I'm learning cool things. Thank you.
No problem. And it just means that thousands upon thousands of people have heard your voice. So this is not even counting your recordings for the Disneyland theme park, and so many people come to Disney World. So how in the world did you hear about this particular job recording for the Disney Company?
Well, for EPCOT, I was just thinking back on this. I recorded that, wow, I think it was probably 1999 because, yeah, it was for 2000. And what happened was, they actually had somebody else come in and sing the lead on it. And I guess that it's really rangy. So I don't think it was working or something. And so they asked me to give it a shot, and I did, and they liked it. So they kept it. So yeah, and I think it was just, I was a session singer around town, and I knew Rick Logan, and he was the contractor on the session, and he called me up. So that's how I got that job, but I still can't believe I got to sing on it. I absolutely love the score that Gavin Greenaway did. I just think it's beautiful.
Jealous. I'm jealous that you got to sing, because I'm a singer too, and I'm like, low key though.
Oh love singers. No wonder. Yeah, I could talk to singers all day. But it is quite a wonderful experience. And my kids, actually, we just went to Disney World with my kids. I have an 8-year-old and a 6-year-old. And we went for the first time. And it was so incredible to get to watch the show and see it through my kids' eyes, you know, because I sang it such a long time ago, and Jackson, my little boy, was telling the people next to us, "That's my mom! That's my mom!" And they were like, "What?" They didn't understand, you know, what was happening. But then, and my little girl just kept hugging me. It was really sweet. So it was fun to watch it with them.
So you told them ahead of time before you saw the show that it is you, or did they just guess it? Okay.
Oh, no. We had talked about it, and they were so excited about going to Epcot to hear the show, so, and see the fireworks. Yeah. So sweet.
So what's it like being back there and finally listening to it again?
Oh, you know, just amazing, especially just being a mom and hearing it through, you know, like through my kids, you know. I just feel really proud of that I got to do it, and I'm just proud that it just has played for so long. And like you said, it plays every night. It's odd to think about that, like every night there, you know, it's showing and people are hearing my voice. I feel, you know, honored to be a part of it. I really do. I know how lucky I am to have gotten to do it. You know, as a singer, you know how hard it is to get those cool jobs like that. So I realize now just, you know, to just relish it and be, you know, feel thankful. So I do.
And did you get to sing with a big choir as you hear in the soundtrack, or did you just record your track separately?
Yes, that's a great question. That's a singer question. And I did. I sang in the choir as well. Yeah. So I think we actually laid the choir down first, and then I went in and sang the lead.
I can clearly hear you in the choir, and I'm like, that's her. Yeah.
They might have had me, yeah, I think like right when I, you know, right when it goes into that part, into the choir, I think they had me out front a little bit, so that's probably why.
Did this job just kind of go right into Disneyland recordings for the holiday seasons and also the fireworks shows as well?
As a matter of fact, I think I might have done the Disneyland job first, as a matter of fact. Don Harper did the music for that, who's a great friend, and he's such a wonderful talent. But and when I sang the lead on that Believe in Holiday Magic, that's when every Christmas they make the park snow. And White Christmas, I sang that as well. And
beautiful.
I loved his arrangement. It was so beautiful, but on that one, even think I was supposed to sing that song either, but he said, "Hey, do you want to give this a shot?" And I said, "Sure." So I went back out into the studio and just sang it down. And I think I only had like maybe 3 takes of that, and they kept it. So, and I think too, there's like a thing on that. I love how there's like a magic, you know, when, if you don't beat it up too much, sometimes I think you just take that, those first couple of takes when that magic is happening, you know? And so, yeah, I love his arrangement.
Do you know how many actual credits you have done for Disney? Or is it more than 5?
Well, I just recently sang for Tokyo Disney, and they have a new show. It's kind of, I guess, their castle lighting show.
Wow.
Yeah. It's called Once Upon a Time. And I just did that like last, I believe, maybe it was March or something. I went out to LA and did that. And it's so beautiful. The music is so beautiful. And the show is fantastic. It's I saw like a mock-up of it. In fact, I think you can go online and actually see that whole show as well. But,
that's great. I didn't even know about it. Nobody's posted anything about it.
I did that. And then I did a bunch of demos for Disney. Like I did the demo for Jessie's song for Toy Story.
No way.
Yes,
oh,
I know.
My God.
I know.
No, the tears.
I know. Yeah, with Randy Newman. So, you know, Toy Story wasn't Toy Story then, you know. It was just like, oh, we have this movie and, you know, can you come in? And Randy Newman was sitting there, and I'm kind of in awe of him. And he was actually writing the song when I came in and, you know, saying, you know, what do you think? Do you like it? And I was like, yes, it's beautiful. And so we actually did it down in the studio where he played the piano at the same time as I did the vocal. And it was really cool because, you know, usually you record them separately, but we did it together. So I got to sing with him live. It was awesome.
That's amazing.
Yeah. And he's super nice guy.
I know there's some stories. I know Judy Kuhn, who is the singing voice of Pocahontas, she says that she was only supposed to be the demo for the Pocahontas songs. And they just were like, you are so good, we want to keep you. I'm confused because you are so good, why wouldn't they not keep you?
That's so sweet of you to say. Oh, I think they had always had in mind Sarah McLachlan to do it. You know, I think they had her in mind because actually when I did the demo, they were saying, you know, we want a Sarah McLachlan type person. So I think they were always had their eyes on her, their ears on her the whole time. So
well, she does an amazing job too. I think it's even a duet. Duet.
So oh my gosh, she's so beautiful. What a beautiful singer she is. Yeah. So she of course knocked it out of the park.
Oh yeah. I think it won an Academy Award.
I bet you're right.
My memory is serving me correctly. Yeah. I don't even know anymore. Now, is there any Disney attraction, like a ride, you know, like Pirates of the Caribbean or Haunted Mansion that you just said, ooh, I love this character. You know what? I'd love to voice them. If I ever got the opportunity, if the opportunity ever came to your door, would you like to voice a character in a theme park attraction instead of just, you know, overall show instead?
Oh, sure. I would do anything. Call me. No, I'm kidding. Nothing comes to mind that, you know, but I just, you know, I love singing. So, and I love to create, you know, characters, and I love the magic of Disney and the stuff that they create and being a part of it. So.
So I have three fun Disney questions I always ask my guests.
Okay.
And they're called the Fab Three questions because they're the Donald, Goofy, and Mickey questions.
Aww.
So let's start out with the Donald one. So as a child, what Disney film would you always like to watch over and over again?
Oh, let me think. Yeah, Pete's Dragon, probably.
Yes!
And I'm sorry, but yeah, I grew up watching.
You would be a great Nora!
Nora, and I love the I'll be your candle on the water, yes.
Yes.
I'll be your candle on the water, yes.
She sang! Yay!
Yay!
I didn't want to ask.
You had to make me sing because all you have to do is say Pete's Dragon, and I sing all those songs. So.
And now our goofy question. What yes. Disney character do you think would be your best friend if you met them in person?
Aw, Minnie Mouse.
Aw.
Don't you think? Yeah.
And our final question, which is the Mickey one. If I asked you to name any Disney song at this very moment, what immediately comes to mind?
Well, since we were talking about Beauty and the Beast, you know. A tale as old as time, true as it can be. That's a beautiful song. That's probably my favorite Disney song.
But thank you so much, Kelly, for coming on the show. This was a lot of fun.
Thank you so much for asking. So sweet. I really appreciate it. I love that you asked me. Thank you so much.
No problem. And listeners, please head to Kelly's website at www.kellycoffey.com. You can also check in the show notes. I have the link in there as well. Kelly, what's your Twitter handle so people can follow you as well?
Oh, what is it? I don't even do Twitter that much. It's Kel Coffey. Let's see. Is that right? Kel. KelCoffey.
I'm trying to scramble to my... that's it.
Yeah, that's it. I'm sorry. I don't do Twitter that much. But no, yeah, if somebody tweeted me, I would totally tweet them back.
And definitely check out her documentary. It's on there as well. You have a YouTube channel, so people can view your documentary on your YouTube channel. I'll also link that in the show notes below as well. So thanks again for coming on the show. We hope to hear more of you singing in the Disney parks very soon, whether it be for Gaston or Belle.
I love it. Thank you so much.